Disturbing story about the treatment of a woman in a Quebec hospital. She recorded video of staff making racist and callous remarks about her while she lay in bed pleading for help. A short time later, she died. Joyce Echaquan, an Indigenous woman, started recording on Facebook Live as she listened to staff insult her, call her stupid, and question her life choices. Her case has led to demands for answers, and the call has reached the highest levels. There are lots of questions, including whether she was denied medical treatment and whether this is part of a pattern of behavior at that hospital. We're going to play portions of the video. Had Echaquan not recorded it just before she died, her story likely would have gone unnoticed.
Tied to a hospital bed in the moments before she passed away, Joyce Echaquan pleaded for help. Instead, she received shocking and racist remarks from hospital staff. Members of the Atikamekw community that Echaquan was part of gathered to mourn.
Il faut que la justice se soit.
A community band council member said there needs to be justice for Joyce.
Yeah.
Echaquan, a 37-year-old Indigenous woman, was the mother of seven children, ranging in age from 7 months to 21 years. Indigenous leaders say her video exposes the realities of systemic racism.
What happened is totally unacceptable. There will be an inquiry, two inquiries, in fact, and the nurses did something unacceptable, and she's been fired.
And every incident of racism needs to be called out. There's absolutely no question about that. But this is, and I think this is what is gut-wrenching about this, is that this is someone who is in their most vulnerable and they are dying having heard racist words expressed towards them. And I can only imagine the impact that that can have on Indigenous communities. And it's part of a pattern that's existing. We have to eliminate that pattern. We have to keep fighting against that pattern.
Good morning.
Calls for answers are growing louder, and the anger is building over how an Indigenous woman was treated in a Quebec hospital. Joyce Echaquan recorded video of her last moments alive as staff made racist and callous comments about her. She lay strapped to a bed and was pleading with them to help her. They appeared indifferent, and she died a short time later.
I want to start off with the situation in Quebec and that young mother, Joyce Echaquan. I know that you've seen that video. I can't even describe how troubling it is to listen to it and to watch it. How did you feel watching it?
Oh, you felt all sorts of emotion. You felt disgusted. You felt angry, disappointed in a healthcare system that should be serving people, our people. You know, Joyce was there asking for help, and instead she got ridiculed. And so it's just people have to say enough is enough of the racism and the discrimination in the healthcare system. And it's no more time for talk. I would urge the Quebec government to implement the Vienne Commission report, you know, to deal with all the systemic racism and not only in the healthcare system, but in the justice system and end this poor service for First Nations people. I would say it's a call on everybody to show the strong leadership that's needed in order to deal with systemic discrimination and systemic racism. You have to call it for what it is, because you need systemic change in the system that is there. And so that has to be overhauled. You know, there's over 140 plus recommendations. It's time to implement them. No more study. Just start working with First Nation leaders, the community leadership as well that's there, and implement all the recommendations. It's clear they have their evidence. You know, and First Nations accessing public services, there's racism, discrimination. And in 2020, that is not acceptable. Fundamental human rights have to be respected. You know, there shouldn't be a two-tiered system for anybody in this country. So it's time to end it now.
Wish I 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 wish
The firing of one nurse doesn't fix anything. There wasn't just one nurse in the video. There were three, he says.
It's not just at the individual.
Cindy Blackstock, executive director of the First Nations Child and Family Caring Society, believes the blame goes beyond just the hospital staff involved.
So often, we look at individual actions, and that's where we focus our attention on racial discrimination. And that's an important place, but often it's reinforced at the systemic level, and even by governments themselves.
I really don't think that we have this kind of way of dealing with First Nation people in our hospitals in Quebec.
But some beg to differ. The executive director of the Native Women's Shelter in Montreal says discrimination against Indigenous peoples in the province is present and needs to be addressed quickly.
This is the norm. That's the problem. And it's only when it's recorded that everyone gets to see it. But it's, you know, if you're not lucky enough to have a cell phone to record it, then, you know, does it happen?
The premier denies systemic racism played a role in Echaquan's death, but Quebec's first Aboriginal surgeon says that is simply untrue. Systemic racism is present here as it is across the country.
That's happening throughout Canada, in Toronto, Winnipeg, Vancouver, Montreal, Halifax. So we have to act as a country, as a province, to go against systemic racism.
Oh! Mother, je vous supplie de m'aider. Je vous supplie, Madame Bennett, de m'aider. Je ne veux pas attendre un an. Je veux en action. Je veux que les actions soient posées dès demain matin. On sait le système que ça prend. La paperasse, l'administration, on sait ce qu'on veut. Manouane, arrêtons de faire des études de marché et tout. Je viens de vous dire c'est qu'est-ce qu'on a de besoin maintenant à Manouane. Peut-être que la communauté va avoir la paix pour pouvoir se reposer à tous les soirs convenablement. Je vous implore, vous deux, très content de m'adresser à vous. Soyez assurés que je vais me battre pour ma communauté. J'ai commencé, j'ai parlé avec vos collègues au niveau régional. Monsieur Dumont, il connaît nos besoins. On a eu des bonnes discussions, je suis content. Mais ça ne suffit pas, les bonnes discussions. C'est agir. On veut agir. C'est dès maintenant que je veux.
We don't need much investigation, said a cousin. We know the facts. We saw the recordings. We saw her condition. Family and friends say this wasn't an isolated incident. According to them, Echaquan had been treated at the Joliette hospital before and had experienced racism during past visits.
It was like a couple of times that she had experienced, and she say herself, you know, weeks before. One day they're gonna kill me.
Shut up.
37-year-old Joyce Echaquan leaves behind her children, a husband, family, friends, and an entire community.